When I'm presenting the idea of reincarnation to people who do not believe in the Indic religions, means people who are from the other faiths, you know, Abrahamic traditions, for us the first challenging question they ask me is this: Mr. Lakhani, do you remember your past life? And I have to tell them, no, I don't remember past life. Then they ask me, how dare you believe in the theory of reincarnation? You don't remember your past life. How can you be sure that you have so many past lives? It, you know, sounds like an outlandish, can't be true. And then I ask the audience sometimes, does anybody here remember their past lives? And so far, I would say 91% do put their hands up, but 99% say, no, we don't remember, Hindus and non-Hindus. So a question arises, how can you believe in a story like that reincarnation is for real? How can you believe in stuff like that when nobody seems to remember their past lives? Surely it's just make believe, just give you comfort in death, that something continues to survive. But I say, there's no validity whatsoever. It's a very challenging question. See, the answer is very simple. Let's think about it. As we get older ourselves, don't we notice that our memory begins to fade? And then we meet a lot of people with dementia who can't even remember their names and remember the names of their wives. Maybe it's a blessing, I don't know. So in a way, we see that as old age creeps up, when the brain functions begin to deteriorate, you begin to lose your memory. Now look, you're going to go through a process of end of life, death, and then being reborn. It's a very traumatic experience. So the superficial memory about names and etc. drops off. Just like, you know, your computer, you could, you know, get a delete thing, you lose all your data. Mm-hmm. The same way, the information that you picked up in this life is easily deleted when you have this transition from one life to another life. So what stays on? You know, how can we possibly learn from our past mistake? The answer is this: what stays on is really the character you built up for yourself. That remains. In fact, throughout our life, you've been chiseling our character. Whether you are a focused individual, whether you are one-pointed, whether you are upright, all these characteristics that you develop for yourself is the only thing that comes with you from one life to another life. And that stays with you, thankfully. Otherwise, our journey will stop straight away. We have to start from scratch every time we are born. So our journey kind of in a way continues or progresses from where we left off. But the only part that we take with us is the character we have fashioned for ourselves. So how do we learn from our past mistakes? Suppose you are a very honest, straightforward, honest person, very, you know, pious, very devout person, and you lead a very devout personal life. That character is going to show itself up in the next life. And suppose in that particular life, you got caught up by, you know, kind of becoming very lovey-dovey and chasing after women or whatever, and you stopped your spiritual progress. What will happen in the next life? You again start having the same characteristic, but hopefully now, in order for you to progress spiritually, you will learn your lesson and say, no, let me focus on spirituality rather than material gains or material possessions. So it is through a difficult process of learning as we go along. So the memory of past life, memory of mistakes doesn't necessarily come with you, but the character that you shape for yourself is the thing that's going to hold you and allow you to progress further from where you left off. This is why it is a very positive. Look, reincarnation is a great deal to offer to the modern world. It gives response, it gives answers to a lot of issues that arise. For example, why are some people so clever? Why are some people so upright? Why are some people so destructive? Reincarnation gives the best answer. In the past life, that individual led a life like that, and that is why it's reflected in the new life. So in a way, reincarnation gives you a better understanding of the psychology of an individual, because every individual is very separate, very different. Even in the same family, they are very different. And the question of why? The genes are the same sometimes, so why? The answer is the character that person is fashioned in the past life is going to become the software he carries with him and starts off his journey from where he left off.
Free e-learning course in Hinduism. To register, please visit www.hindu-academy.com.
Talks on Hinduism, sponsored by People Care, encouraging caring for the elderly in their own homes. For more information, please visit peoplecare.com.